Coming at you on Monday, post non-farms. Bang bang, 517. How you doing? How you like me now? You don't know me, son. Release. Wow. Shocker for all of us. Where do we go from here? That was, where do we go from here now that all of our children are growing up? Not much on the calendar today. The big early week moment is Powell tomorrow, 6 p.m. Swiss time. He's going to, I think, be more aggressive and let everybody know that his little fireside chat at after the Fed needs to be pissed on. And so I think the dollar is going to go higher here. We're going to see a little bit of risk off. It's interesting. Overnight, Aussie collapsed. It didn't collapse. Let's just. Dollar went higher at the open overnight everywhere. So gap down here a little bit in Aussie, down to 68.89. We're back here at 37. This is a sell here between 30 and 60. Weirdly, more JP Morgan over, I guess over the weekend or Friday, pulled back their Aussie cash rate hike scenario. And they think that RBA is going to stand pat here. That is tomorrow, 4:30 a.m. Swiss time. So if you're in the U.S., you can trade that 10:30 p.m. But 4:30 a.m. we might be awake, but normal people are not. But pulling back the Aussie call, not going to help. Considering we're risk off, stocks are just bouncing around here at the bottom. Dollars bid. Anyway, short Aussie here. Early doors. It's 5:30 a.m. London time. Just on this move back up, we filled the gap, and now it feels like we're just going to have resistance here between 30 and 60. with more of a continuation of dollar higher. Dollar yen, there's some BOJ replacement news coming up and around. Again, gapped open, dollar gapped open. Pretty big gap there, right? So hasn't been filled yet. Probably gets filled at some point today. We just bought some at 60 on this pullback. We will be buying on this gap fill, dollar yen as well. Have to see how that goes. So long dollar yen, short Aussie is kind of the way. Let's look at rates here. Here's the non-farm. Bang, 351. Here's the gap up. Bang, 358. So you're buying this, you're selling tens, buying yield per se, somewhere 350 and 353 today. We think this is going to continue. You'll see this is sort of a theme, what we're thinking. Let's go to Euro. Euro's going to be a little stickier. It's just thicker, right? More liquidity. Did gap as well. We've already filled that gap back up to 107.98. Here we are at 94. No real feel for Euro here. We're not going to really fuck around with this. We do want to just acknowledge that the next big support is 107.65. If you look at it on the dailies here, this 34-day means nothing. The 200-day is 103, so there's a lot of room here for Euro to consolidate. What do we think is probably going to happen? I think we're probably 106, 109 for the next 4 weeks. We'll have to see, but no bee in my bonnet for Euro. Same thing, dollar-Swiss. Dollar-Swiss can go higher with higher rates. It will go higher, but it'll be sticky, right? There are too many longs out there in dollar-Swiss. There's just too many people long dollar-Swiss, so it's hard for it to go up. Euro-Swiss got this trend line here. last week we were buying Euro Swiss on dips. It kind of worked. We weren't patient enough. You know, we ended up selling 99.90s. We bought 75, 65s, 55s, and 35s. So we did make some money on that position. But obviously, as soon as we squared, that shit went up to 1.0040. Annoying. Here's your support line in Euro Swiss. If you want to trade this purely technically, go ahead. If you think that Euro dollar will be sticky on the downside and dollar Swiss will have to crawl higher because of this whole higher rate scenario, Euro Swiss could go higher. But if you're worried about the global macro risk backdrop, as in stocks get smashed, you got to be a bit careful with this. So we're leaving Euro Swiss alone this week. It was like a five-star idea last week that we just basically botched. Annoying. Euro sterling's overextended. You can see this is, you know, if you believe in the math here, this is 2.5, almost 3 sigma up at 89.81. I think the cat's out of the bag here, and you can sell high ones in Euro sterling going forward, right? So today we're going to try and sell 89, 85 to figure if we get up there. No real, you know, no real wild conviction here at 50, but you can see this is extended. Probably get some consolidation today. And it's basically just a gentle range trade, right? Like no wild conviction, and there's no really great story there. UK is fucked. But is it as fucked as everybody thinks it is? Probably not. Anyway, let's go to gold. Are you going to get a chance to sell gold at between 1895 and 1900? I seriously doubt it. When gold starts doing this kind of massive $60 move from the highs, it usually goes a lot further than people think. This is probably going to go to 1800. First initial support's 1830. Do you want to sell it here at 1876 as a spec? I mean, you could, but, you know, the risk reward basically sucks, right? Where are you going to leave your stop above 1920? Don't be a dumbass. As a spec move, I wouldn't do that. If you're long gold and you're fucked, I would consider hedging sooner rather than later. I think this has further to go. I'm just going to pull up Euro Norway here because also extended 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up days. This is reflecting crude. Euro Norway over 11 for the most part has been a pretty good sell. Many of you will remember in 2021 where this shit went to 13 briefly. You can see we were fooling around here with Fibonacci's and whatnot. That was a very hectic time in Euro Norway. But in general, Euro Norway above 11 is a sell. These highs here are 11.18, 11.20. So we're getting into stretchy stuff with Euro Norway. If you think crude's going to base at 70, which we do, U.S. is going to fill strategic petroleum with crude at 70. We're at 73 now, so 70 is still $3 away. Careful, and again, careful of your risk reward. But on the day, buying crude between 71 and 69 looks interesting to us. So we don't think crude's going to fall out of bed here. And if you don't think crude's going to fall out of bed and you're more comfortable trading FX, have a look at Euro Norway on the stretchy. Dollar China, we bought this morning in very small size. Just on the pullback here, this line eventually did break. We've been talking about dollar China forever. We're not talking about the fucking balloon, some fucking little Chinese condom floating above America. We don't care. China has all the data on America that they want. They don't need any extra data. I don't understand the kerfuffle. I mean, I'm glad they In a sense, I'm glad they shot it down because it was a bit of a fuck you, right? Floating a big balloon over somebody else's country. Imagine if America flew a big balloon over Shanghai. What would happen there? But again, this is just a technically driven trade. Stronger dollar. It got down to 678.56. We put a tiny trade on at 80. Looks like it's 50 points higher, but remember, 50 points in dollar China is like 10 points in euro dollar, so it's no big deal. And we put such a small amount on, it's like tiny dick stuff. But this has nothing to do with balloons or whatever. It's just strength in dollar and a very strong technical pattern that finally broke. That 679 seller got taken out on Friday. Now this becomes support, long dollar China. So it's similar to long dollar yen. Little bit. It's actually not more vol. Pips wise, it feels like more vol, but obviously, 130 points in dollar yen is 682 points in 680 points in dollar China. So just be careful how you size that, and be careful what you're trying to do, right? If you're trying to get 100 points in euro dollar, that you got to get 600 points in dollar China. So I keep saying this to people, and I don't know why. It's pretty fucking obvious. Crypto's a little bit lower, but nothing too crazy, not doing too much. Anyway, I've said enough. Powell is the big moment. He's going to come in 6 p.m. on Tuesday. If you want to trade Aussie rates and wake up, I applaud your efforts, or stay up if you're a North American. Otherwise, we're long dollar yen, long dollar China, short Aussie here at the open. When London does come in, they should smack the pony in that direction, according to experience and what we think today. Good luck out there, people, and I will see you tomorrow.